derive linear and exponential functions. So this is a lesson on how to use GeoGebra to help understand this question. So I'd like you to open up GeoGebra. If you haven't opened it up yet, pause the video and open GeoGebra. Now the Chromebooks, your GeoGebra interface is different than one on either a PC or a desktop. I'm using a Mac, so it looks a little different, but the procedures are basically the same. So I've opened up GeoGebra, got it open, and now what I want to do is I want to graph each of these functions, f of x and g of x. Now I do that as I enter that information in the input bar. Your input bar might be in a different location, but mine is at the bottom. I'm going to change that position by going to the options, advanced, and I'm going to move mine up to the top here. So there it is, it's up here at the top. So now we'll enter the first function. I type it in as is, no difference. F of x with parentheses equals negative 3 raised to the x power. Now my raise button is shift 6, which is the caret top, x plus 1. So there's my first function, it's an exponential. That's it. I'm going to drag that over here onto the screen. You can do the same thing. I'm also going to click. Oh, where'd it go? Let's see. Oh, there it is. Little glitch there. It's kind of strange. But there it is. And I am going to change the graphics a bit by going to graphics. Change that to a little larger. I'm having a little hiccup here. It's strange. Medium, and then changing it to green. Also go bold. Second step would be to graph the next function, g of x. And I'm typing it just as I see it. So there you have it. Two functions, I'm also going to drag that over, change the scale. So what I'd like to do now is add a grid. And how do I do that? So make sure I'm on the pointer option there. Click on the screen and click grid. Nice. Now go back to the graphics, get rid of those options, and just look at what I have. So how do I analyze this function, and how do I analyze the rate of change, which is the slope? So this is kind of a new concept. What I'd like to do is look at some input-output tables and see how the slope changes for each of these graphs. So how I do that is I'm going to begin by taking the information on GeoGebra and create a table, just like the table here. If you look closely, I'm going to create that using GeoGebra. This is kind of important, so pay attention. So how do I create that table? Well, I'm on GeoGebra. I go to the View button. See that? I want to view the spreadsheet. Now, the spreadsheet is made up of rows and columns. And I want to title my spreadsheet X, F of X, and G of X. One more time. I want to title my spreadsheet. First column, x, second column, f of x, third column, g of x. So when I enter those texts, you have to use quotations. Quotations, x, close quotations. Try it again. Quotations, f of x, with parentheses, quotations. And last one was g of x in quotations. Without the quotations, it's not text. GeoGebra acts funny if you're trying to enter text. Without quotations, you get mathematical approximations occurring. You don't want that. So I think I want to center all those. There you go. Now look at my input and output table. Input x, output f of x and g of x. So what I will do is for my input, I think I want to choose some values here. And the values I choose are going to come from these values there. So I think the important part of this graph kind of starts about here. See that? And we get all this other stuff down here. But let's look at the x coordinates right there, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, negative 4, then over 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, positive 5. So I'm going to choose those. I'm going to choose negative 4, negative 3, all the way to positive 5. This one. Do the same thing. Those are all these points on the x-axis. Now there's output values, but those output values are determined by the functions given. So how do you type those functions in the spreadsheet? Well, what you do is you use the equal sign telling the computer, the spreadsheet, that you're typing a function. So the function I'm typing is, let's start off with f of x, which is negative 3 to the x power plus 1. So f of x, but the x value is negative 4, and that's found here in A column, row 2. So I'm going to type in A2. So f at A2, or f of A2, or f of negative 4. So that value, by entering it, you get an answer of 0.99. Now, if you take a look real close here, your f of x there is very close to 1. You see that? Very close to 1, right? At negative 4. So that's pretty darn good. And so I want this to compute all of these f of x values for negative 3, negative 2, negative 1. I can do that because this formula allows me to do that by dragging on the lower right-hand corner of the box, dragging downward, by clicking and dragging, and it will compute all the values of f of these given inputs. And so there you have it. So wow, that's pretty cool. Now, let's look at g of x, same idea. Equal sign, g parentheses of x, which is a2. So it gives me 6. Let's check that out. At negative 4, all the way up, positive 6 is the output. It works. So now take that formula, drag the lower right-hand corner of that box downward, and there you go, you have the outputs. Pretty nice, isn't it? Now what I want to do here is I want to show you a couple things here. So it looks like the rate of change for g of x is always negative 2. And just look at the difference. From 6 to 4, you're subtracting 2. From 4 to 2, you're subtracting 2. From 0 to negative 2, you're subtracting 2. So that's the negative 2. See that right there? That's the negative 2 rate of change. Here, though, look at the rate of change. It's more like negative 0.04. You see that? Not very big. Definitely smaller than negative 2, so it's not greater. But from here to here, it gets a little larger. It's about 0.07. Here to here, it gets a little larger. It looks like it's, 0.23 or 0.22. And then here, from here to here, it gets significantly larger. It's about 0.33. And from here to here, it's a change of negative 2, right? Which is equal to the slope here, negative 2. But here's a change from here to here, from 2 to 8, that output value. That change is 6 units. Wow, so that's a greater change. So you see that? So between 0, 1, and 2, something happens. The rate of change becomes greater. And so let's see if we can find that rate of change. So I'm thinking somewhere between 1 and 2, actually, between 0 and 1, I believe, the rate of change changes significantly. And so how you find that without finding the slope, like I was doing there, is you use GeoGebra to calculate the slope at the tangent line of a given point on each of these functions. So let's look at the red line. Check this out. Let's place a point on the red line. Let's draw a tangent line to that point. And so we choose this option. There it is, tangent line. So it may not make sense to you, but by selecting the point and the line, it draws another line on it, passing through that point. So let's do the same thing here. Pick a point. Pick that same point and the curve. Try it again. There you go. So a tangent line passes through that point at exactly one spot on the curve. See that? And so that line changes steepness as it travels on the curve. Now the reason why this line doesn't change steepness is because the line in this case is not even a curve, is the same slope. So the tangent line is the same as the original line. So what's the slope? Well, there's a button you can use on GeoGebra to find the slope. There it is, see that? So clicking on the point calculates the slope. And as I move that point, the slope doesn't change. You see that? Kind of great, isn't it? Now, if I move this though, it does change slopes. Let's calculate that slope. And so there it is. Went too many times, let's delete that. So where does this slope become greater than -2 in terms of change? At about right there. About right there. So what's the value of x? Well, the value of x at that particular point B is about 0.54, so it's a little over a half. And so we found it. So every single input value after 0.5 creates a slope that is greater than -2. See how that's becoming steeper? Now it's -9. And so the interval where the rate of change is greater, if you look at that here, you can see that, right? The rate of change becomes greater, happens after 0.5. So I'm going to write that. And this is writing so choppy. So this interval notation, f of x has a greater rate of change at 0.5 comma positive infinity. So that's just signifying all the values of x that are greater than 0.5. Another way of writing that would be, x is greater than 0.5. Now, where is g of x changing faster? Well, it occurs when these values here are less than -2, and that's anything less than 0.5, those values. So it looks like g of x now be written as x is less than 0.5.